Okay. You know, I'm glad I reach up here and thing, get with you, and you know, you can know me lifestyle, but you know, sometimes it just feel like your life gonna be an end someday, you understand what I'm saying? So
or it could be better.
No, they ain't got no betterment inside me life or anything. Nah. I don't feel so, you know what I mean? I don't feel so. Not in this life. Maybe in another life. I know so much of things that, you know, cannot be told, you know what I mean?
Just behind the main streets of Georgetown, the capital of Guyana, there is a small shanty town. I had passed these streets many times on a previous trip, but never ventured in. I've come back to explore the forgotten cracks of this city. Fascinated by life in the ghetto. I'm driven to learn what draws some to despair and others to joy, some to violence and others to peace. Of the many people I meet, I become close to three. Their stories do not intersect, but their lives run parallel.
This is the voice of Guyana. It is 12:30. There is no announcement of death, nor is there any message at this time. The next announcement of death and messages can be heard at 20:35.
Omila welcomes me into this intimate moment. She is expecting her fifth baby. The fourth was lost a year ago to dysentery. Survival in the slum is day to day. Disease is rampant.
It's only a few, one out of a million just come out, you understand, to successful. You're doing something, you know what I mean? But 95%, 99% is left in the slum all the time. You know, just keep punishing, keep suffering. Grow old, get old, get crippled, wherever you left in your house, you know what I mean? Just like they say when my name is got off. Let me come and show you. Let me take you and show you that part there, so you can see. People really don't like me because they say I'm very ignorant and very this storm. So they don't want too much dealings with me. You know, they don't want to mess with me too much. You know, we don't want getting maybe an empty because I ignorant this here. You know.
It became clear that Peter wanted to confess something very dark to the camera.
Mind your business. Who you are talking to? Yeah?
What happened with you? Somebody come to you?
Oh, I thought so. Hi, Miss Gato. Oh, Nicholas, you come. This is, these kids is all of her own. You understand? She got them like mostly about 4 or 5 of them, you understand? You know, so this is things that always go on every day, you understand? Then they struggle every day. You find it's a whole set of advantage then, you understand? And it's been taking over poor people in Guyana, you know? And it has corrupt your mind. Hunger is put you to hunger for make you do things and evil things too. Like I done, you understand, in my life, you know what I mean? I done a lot of evil things. I mean, the same people around you will tell you, you understand, saying I do a lot of serious things in this life here, so you know what I'm talking about. Right? You know, it's not too late for I correct my life anyhow. You know, but I stay living upon the edge, my brother, you understand?
Children to go to school together at things and books and so, oh my gosh, it's tough. I don't know, I really need them to go out to school, but expense, everything is money.
When I first met Auntie, she spoke freely about a history of violence that her family endured, but she had never wanted to be filmed. Today is the first day that she is comfortable with the camera.
First of all, I was being abused by my husband. Yes, I was being abused several times by... He was being very violent and abusive. I had 6 children at the time when the abusing started. I never got to the police. I had to waste some time. If I did go to the police, I might even see my dad more fast. I used to leave it like that and let it calm like that.
Auntie now lives outside of town with 4 of her 6 children. There is a common thread to her story, as many mothers are left abused and children fatherless.
Everywhere I go to live, he come in and searching for us. He come in and find me all over the place. He come in and find me. He's not leaving me. Four days before Father's Day, he came and he created a scene. We had to rush and get him out of the yard. And up to the latest child, which is he, had a piece of wood in his hand. So I know he can't do nothing now. He's scared to do anything now.
As I watch the children play, they seem oblivious to the harshness of the environment. Many adults cannot read. I wonder what hopes and dreams the children have, if they dream to leave here.
Stay right behind. No.
No, don't come down here.
No.
All right.
No, I didn't die. But buy it, you know. But I buy it, card yourself.
I call it an idiot.
We got more of that thing in Canada than y'all do.
Very. Look, video, look straight. There's a documentary you want to do it.
No documentary, you carry it outside. You gotta send some money for us to live better. Don't put me on camera.
Well, you gotta be on camera for
me. Here it is. This is my
this
home.
This is where I live.
This is my home.
When the rain fall, the water better sup all your bed, everything the water wetter. This going on Guyana camera, on Guyana television. Don't put me on Guyana TV. We need help. When the sun is shining, it's good, and when the rain is falling, it's different. Right now, we gotta move from here because somebody else bought the place. And they got this in court. All right, we gotta find somewhere to live. If you don't find place to live, they throw you on the street. Because it's not our place, it's somebody else's place. You know? Somebody else's place. And I pray a lot. I cry a lot and I pray a lot to get out of here. I need to come out of here.
As I wander through winding corridors that weave together to make the ghetto, I find the lives that form chapters of the shantytown story.
Sir, they easy with me. Right now, I don't give a go make money. Cause Guyana hard. If you don't hold your head, you go out there, fear me, you're prostitute and all them things. Especially when you come from a ghetto, poverty. But you gotta come out to the poverty, make yourself somebody sour. And I make myself what I am and what I is. Me make myself not what, I mean trying to be down, I'm trying to be up. I'm looking for be a way up in life, not come be down all the time. So I'm gonna talk to a man now.
Hi, hi, put that on the ground now, put that on the ground. Hi.
What do y'all do to survive?
Me? I sell a lot of fruit juice. You know? I sell juice, by the way, you know?
Everybody ain't gonna believe in God, eh?
Mm. You gotta believe in somebody. You understand? Gotta got somebody above we. You know? So, somebody keeping us. Being just, you know? Being a just, you know? You wanna say something?
Since you say you come from Tiger Bay, you're the thief, you're the murderer, and you're this, you can't tell people you come from Tiger Bay.
Tiger Bay
is a body, he's a body, you know. They want to free me. Just because they come from the ghetto, stuff like that, they want to try to say, I thief the thing. All they want to do is just get a good education, that's all I do. And them children, those are like, the children get a good education. You know, they don't really know certain things, you know. Yeah, just somebody to teach you, and you catch on.
I find myself surrounded by many children. The streets are a playground.
Hi, my name is Tom. I have a wife, two kids. I work at a butter factory. One day, my boss came along and said, Sam,
are you busy? I said, no. He said, turn this way with your left hand.
My name is Omila. I have four kids. I've been living here all my life, 31 years. Well, life here is a struggle, but still we have to make it every day for survive.
Yes, sir, it's really good.
For you?
Sir, I go to school. And so
me, your
me, your Cordelia, Rihanna, Andrew. Thank you, sir, for this permission.
Do you want to shut up your shit mouth?
Girl, you don't get two girl. But you are not your car last year when my son shoot and die. One with me from my first relationship, you have three big children. And one my son you shoot by police. So he say he want no more buy. You are not a girl.
Last time he came to church, they never came in Sunday.
My head!
Come
up from
there!
The guy that robbed people in Guyana.
So we want me to
I know what you do for a living or what you've done for a living.
Alright. Starting. You see, too much people around me if I really talk like that right now. You know. Them children, we go to another little quiet place than this is, so you can get it better and, you know, the whole fullness for me like that. You know?
Oh, you're shy around all these, yeah.
A little, you know what I mean?
I don't want no video.
You want video? No, don't video, though.
Don't video? No.
The street is why you have to pick up me money, pun. Meet couple big man, you understand, saying, get a little food from them. When I meet food, I meet drugs.
Hello?
But I deal with drugs and I sell drugs to people and I know it's hurting people's life like that too.
What are you smoking, boy?
Huh?
What are you smoking?
What thing are you smoking?
Yeah, what thing are you smoking?
A conclusion, decision, and vision.
Well, after he was under the influence of drugs, they said that the drugs take full control over them and they're doing these kind of things. But you know, I don't really, don't got malice or hatred because I know God takes care of everything. Yes, I haven't done him anything wrong, though he do me so much. I never got to the station, said that I'm going to lock him up. Left him to God. God got his own time waiting for him. Only God knows the time and the hour.
Since I growing up, I selling drugs. I grow between me mother alone. I never grow knowing a father from the time I born. Yeah? And let me tell you something, I grow knowing my mother as a whore. Yeah, I saying, and this is how I live my life, knowing my mother all the time. That's my mother. You understand what I'm saying? She was a prostitute on the road, on the streets. You understand what I'm saying? Man used to bust up she fucking head. You understand? Yeah, man used to bust she head when she trying, forget the extra dollar out of the pocket, you understand what I'm saying? Lash she head, buckle and bust up she head. So when she come home 3-4 o'clock in the morning, I used to be the only child. Used to be awake, waiting for when she come home, you understand what I'm saying? Sometimes I used to jump over the wall and fellowship on the streets. She didn't used to know that I used to there behind she, but I used to there sitting down and then ducking by a fence or somewhere and watching she from tail up the road, peeping she, watching she doing prosecution on the streets just so mind we just put a plate of food on the table. When I see a man lash me more inside your head and all them things and doing them things though, I say I gotta do something about this. You know? I got to do something about this. So I got to make a choice. I who take me mother off the streets, you understand, from prosecution by selling drugs and doing certain things on the streets, you understand, for survive. My mother don't have no education at all. So that's why these things that will happen to her in her life. And she now, you know what I mean, like using it as a weapon now. She just corrupt in the messed up world she left in. And she'd even take off all her clothes in the yard, naked. You understand what I'm saying? She don't care what she do. You know, she's like me. I guess she mentality. You understand what I'm saying? I just don't care what I do. You know what I mean? Yeah. Because she don't respect the things them that I do for her. You know what I mean? The things them that I done for her and risk my life out there. Tell the honest truth, you understand, saying it's not a joke. I just be telling she. You know, cause some of the times I just feel like killing she. You know what I mean? Just kill share and just, you know what I mean? Just kill my own self just at all. Well, I don't believe in suicide. It means that if I kill share, I can go and do a lot of more things.
When I turned off my camera, Peter told me his first violent experience was as a young child. He had stabbed his sister in the neck over a small squabble. I can't help but wonder what the fate of this boy will be. Does Amila fear that violence will take another child?
Usually my main basic income is I string hair. I do that and get small change, and then I got my husband, he assists me. And he works labor, or he buy things and sell back.
I'm gonna marry her. This guy named Carlton here, sir. He's gonna be my best man. This guy here. I'm gonna marry him.
He's gonna be my flower girl. These two girls gonna be my, you gonna be my flower girl? Tell the guy yeah.
Yeah.
Tell the guy you gonna be my flower girl.
Yeah. Good afternoon.
You can be my flower guy. Say yes, guy.
Yes,
guy. I just like watch movies, all these movies. I just stay in here, watch my movies.
You stay in that house? All the kids?
Yeah, the kids and my mother and my sister.
Your mother and your sister?
But I like it over here, man. See that movie you're writing about Hope? It'll be a good movie. I'm telling you. I've been just hoping all the time.
It's starting to get heavy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Enough movement, though.
Oh, yeah. That's cute.
That's why it's like all me and my partner be together, because when I was young, I didn't grow up with my dad and children need to have both of their parents while they're growing up.
Come on, they work, say they come and clean. And I know nobody never come and clean them. It's you, me, clean them. You're getting some bad or worse, you know what I'm saying? I need to get my kids out. I need to get my kids out, man. I remember the last son I was 18 years old already. force me, you all believe right together. Kill me, son. Family living there, I seen your family every day. You know what I'm saying? I live with all. He said, you know what I'm saying? Gonna do nothing towards your family. I left the father for make a judgment. You understand me? I made the father make a judgment. Then I seen people who family kill me, me son, you know what? You know, you tell me you kill me, son, you did do it. Maybe I will use a president, yeah, every country. You know, me ain't got no problem as a poor man. It's how we live as a poor person. You see? This country ain't got no justice, you know what I'm saying? That poor people ain't got no rights. You know what I'm saying? Poor people like me. A lot of people ain't got no rights. But I just live humble, you know what I'm saying? I live humble. I get up, go to work every day, you know? I ain't no sin, I ain't for the boss here, but change my life. Because I feel for other people.
Certain thing you went through, you know? You've been in prison already. When I went pregnant with the last baby, he went in prison for a couple months. Because a man come and say, but he sell you something and the police, they lock you up and stuff. But we still got thing and he come out and... But he knew such things and that thing, but he said them things make sense. And he changed his life.
But the main object for the grace of God, if I could get money, I could build a nice little thing. This is what I got here, so for the land I got in tuition. That's all I need in life. Just like me 50, the life begins at 40. You understand me? That's how I get serious. I never get in a dance, I ain't but when I get old in life first, I know them things waste some money. I got children. I got open a car. I don't even drink a beer, but I'm drinking no beer, me no man. I don't live them life. You gotta be strong. You understand me? So I just watch me life. You understand me? I got 3 children first, one day left 2. I got another 3. When you get 1, you're gonna make it 4, you're gonna make it 6. Back to 6 again. You understand me? Good. The 6. And look how much more wrong me. Cause all this is life. You understand me? I put on all these things, small. Everything.
I follow the children away from Emila's home and into a small, crowded building housing many families.
7 of we live in there. What? More of your numbers, all right? Dennis, me, California, Calvin. 7 of we live in there.
There's on 6. Your mother makes 7. 7 of them.
32. Remember, you have 5 and you have 2, says 32. 32
persons.
32 persons
live in this whole thing.
3 people got used one pipe. That's the whole area, everywhere. You row, you gotta live quiet.
Moko quiet.
You wanna get out?
Baby quiet.
Linden quiet.
Pleasant quiet.
Huh?
Hey, don't open up, move over this
kid. Just wanna move out here.
I look at myself in the mirror and I smile. Alone, I would smile. Before I sleep, I look myself in the mirror again and I just smile. You know, it takes away a lot of things from me. It makes me feel happy. All that I want is to come up from the side. This particular place, I want to come up. This is about your poor way how you live in and how you conduct yourself. That is what counts. Not a big set of money. I live here without a loan in this great place where you sit here. One door where you peep in there, you can't got no window. This is how I live.
ain't got no way for cook. I ain't got no place to bed, no for shit or for piss. I buy a place in Belfield, and I waiting for the government for help me, out with something for a bill. So if y'all could help me out with that, I would be very, very glad to come out from inside of here. That is all I have to tell you, nothing more. It's the truth.
See the area, there's mostly is business properties there around the surrounding area. So they're trying to get rid of the community. Even though they say everybody's supposed to clear out to the area soon, still more people coming for leave.
Here I feel exposed. I've become a tourist of poverty. I'm reminded that they don't share my freedom. As I watch these people in the confines of the environment, I wonder who I'd become if I was left with no way out of the ghetto.
Hey.
As you grow up and see everybody, and you wanted to feel how it is to be a mother. I had a young baby, this one who had 3 hours day. She had gas too.
I'm getting my grandmother. I'm going to live with her married again. Meet your uncle here. I tell you, go rent off your skin now.
You bet?
Yes, you know already. Go rent off your skin, put on your red suit. Glang.
Oh, let me speak your truck. What day?
Well, my mother's a single parent. And she would bake. She would bake pone, red cake, and so on, sell. From an early age, we had to start learning how to provide for ourselves, because there were so many of us, and then our mom, she was just a single mom.
He's asking Chow when he ready, if he are a Chow, so when they ready for asking for money, so when they ready for movement materials and make a ice and go.
The government, them give we the land and everybody's supposed to get 100,000 worth of material. And now majority of the people get no material. Because the man where they put in control, he did the own thing.
Something the land because the people them don't saying they taking back the land, they taking back the land from you if you don't do nothing with it. Like
this is all just all you went and do. You don't get it.
October the 2nd, you say. Okay. But you said nobody know the right date.
Because sometimes it's be 2 weeks before or two weeks after.
Different times when I was younger, my mother was abused. And so I always tell myself I wouldn't want to be abused when I get older. My daughter's father, he was very jealous. And if he own friends, them come around and would gaff and he would rowing up on my hit you on them thing. Enough time you are afraid, but then I say if I see my mom, she move on from abusive relationship. I say I could do it too, and I just decide to elevate myself and start doing things for myself. Me and Chow start dealing. And I just say I can settle down with Chow. He's been good to me all the way.
Omila seems to speak so casually about her abusive ex. It makes me wonder what buried emotions she may have.
You know, it's hard to find a good woman. You know, sometimes it's hard to find a good man too. Same way it go too, you know, same way it go. So, I love she all the time. You know what I mean? I love she like a ghetto man. Like, you never believe that they ain't got nobody in the ghetto, like, got love. We end up married and I start to build a good home with her and thing. You know, she got them Amerindian thing in share, you understand? You know, I was fucking around here, fucking there, fucking in all over the place. It's simple like that, you know what I mean? Because them is the things that she started doing, you know? So, when you see she started doing them thing, one time I forgive share, me not share and do share anything. Second time, come again, bleeding to me. From there, things just start to get real sick, you know what I mean? I start to not share. And every time she go out and do them things, I start to not share. You know what I mean? You got no reason for do them things. I looking out for you, you know. So from there, I was never no more Mr. Nice Guy from there. You know, my life does take a big change in it. You know, I just turned mean and ruthless. Started to do all these things while telling you about, you know. Had no more love, you know.
Peter seems unable to escape the past his mother had left him. His violence reflects a feeling that women in his life had failed him. Charu is gentle, but I wonder about the shadows of Amila's past. Does she still suffer from those memories?
Some people would have done given up certain situations they've been through, but I still ask Father for the faith and the strength to be strong. And we have to believe in somebody, something.
You think I know it's not nice? Thiefing and robbing people and them things, you think I know it's not nice? I know it's not nice, but it's just that I gotta survive. You know what I mean? The devil is a busy man. There's the old fullness. The devil is a busy man. And so long as I live in places like this, eh, so, I'm being comfortable. And I always uncomfortable. The devil always busy. You know what I mean? He can use me and he can use millions and more like me. You know what I mean? In the ghettos them.
Lock you. Mom. Lock you. You buy it?
So he had a dream, and he believed that God has given him that dream, that my wife was cheating on me. That's my mom.
The father closed up the whole house all over, turned on the TV louder like nobody couldn't hear.
Swing it open. That one doesn't count.
So he took us in the kitchen. He put a pot of boiling hot water on the stove, and he took a cutlass, a knife, and razor blades he bought, freshly bought from the store.
The children were there behind me, shouting and screaming, hollering and all these things, and if they only holler, he started beating them and all too, but he don't damage them like how he just damaged me. He didn't joke me no way, just marking my skin like this with a knife. When he mark you with his knife, you can't holler. I tell you plain, you can't holler. Don't make no noise on these things. In one day alone, I experienced something like, let me say about 30, 35 to 36 cuts and chops in my body. Yes, I actually bleed out my entire body with blood.
I guess he cut and cut until he couldn't cut no more of her. And when he was finished, he had a bottle of gramazone poison, and he was going to poison all of us.
He mixed it in a 1/2-gallon ice cream container and gave me to drink. No, he gave the one of the little boy to drink for us, and I started to cry hard. When I started to cry, he gave me a next chop. That is when I get it here. And I scrambled the bowl out of the boy hand, one of the little boy, and by the cut all in the fingers and the hand and them thing. And so the blood slide, I leaned the bowl to my mouth, but it didn't get my mouth. All fall on top of my stomach like this, because the blood from my hand slide the bowl out. And that is how the poison get to throw away. That was like life in hell.
They say people, you mustn't live with regrets, but I live with regrets in my life, you know, things that happened to me, things that I do in my life, you know what I mean? You know, things that I didn't like that happened to me too. You know, I live with a lot of regrets. Yeah. It just happens all the time with me and them. You know what I mean? Sometimes I end up hurting a whole family. Like 4 or 5 persons in a family end up chopping them up, fucking up their hand and foot. Things that I don't need to do, you understand, saying them thing though when I get ignorant, you understand, why don't need to do? I end up doing, you know, like my whole sight that's gone. I don't like know myself no more. You know. I don't see myself no more until I done do what I gotta do. You know, I don't know what I's be doing, you know. Tell the honest truth. You know, only y'all don't know. Or people don't know though. I don't when I get into the way there, I don't see myself no more. I don't know even know if I'm alive or anything until when it done wear off for me in the moment. You know, I don't know. Is that crazy? But I don't think I'm crazy.
He get together with the children and started to clean up my skin, go and buy drugs at the drugstore and try to put on the cuts and all these kind of things. Buy pain tablet and give me to drink and put me to lie down and sleep and so. And he stood there with me actually like 3 days. After see like he wanted to start up back again because he was still smoking the drugs. I time him one day when he wasn't around and then I walk out of the house with the children then. But you see the hardest with me, I didn't have nothing because even though I was with the father, everything used to be in his name. So even when I walk out the house, me got nothing.
It's really hard on her. Sometimes she would come home and I would see she won't eat. She would go to bed just like that and she would give us all we want and she would deprive herself from... She would deprive herself from... She won't eat, and she would take it on a lot.
And she can't seem to fill it up. There's a hole in my towel, and my heart can't mend it up. But why does she try to find an occasion to mend it up? When all the while searching hard for identity that she's not. But girl, I like your business. I like your business. Girl, I like your business. Whoa, let's have a good time.
Man, choose right for you.
heavy traffic blocking.
We want to share your passion.
Which one you like better?
Which I like cherry.
All right, I like cherry.
No more than one. Six.
Oh. What's up?
Hey, what's up? How are you doing?
Hey, I got beat you. And you too, me.
They come and beat me now.
Hello. Hello. Young cook? Young cook? You cook? Oh shit, me cook now, you know. Y'all got food. Y'all got food. Hello. Hello.
Little auntie talking to
you. Hi, tell them send the food for you hear? Don't forget, right? All right, good girl.
It's a gummy too, yeah.
In the poorer homes, you find that there is a lot of love and sharing, and some people might say we got more than she. We even got to talk to she, or them got to be friends with you because them got more than you. But we're never done. We are all human, so we have to have love for one another.
So you are passionate.
Passion, not my cherry.
The cherry, thank you. Punch it. I'm the one arm man. You know you have to punch for the one arm man. Yeah, the one arm man. You have to punch it for me, baby. Thank you, sweetheart.
You don't fight on nothing, the little that you have, be contented with. And God always will provide for the next day.
From nowhere, a woman appeared just like that. When she heard my story and I told her the story, she said she was going to help me with the house lot. And in 3 months' time, I saw a truck pull up in front of me with one set of material on it. And a man jump off the truck and come to me and tell me, he laughing and he say, I must tell you, thanks. I said, why must tell you thanks for? He said, look, you see all them thing with up on the truck is your own. I come for Billy house. And in 3 months' time, I get a house.
You excited for the next baby? Are you?
Or sure, I'm excited.
But I feel sad to know that I passed through so much, and now is the time that I get a little peace of mind. Now is the time I discover that I'm facing cancer. I'm a diabetic, you know? All this cancer. It's a pain in the joints, in the jawbone. In the jaw, they say the cancer is in the muscles, in the muscle itself here, right? My mouth cannot open to a certain extent, and it's here pain. And every time I talk, it clicking like a clock. It going click, 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 you know?
When I arrive at Amila's home, Charu tells me she is in the hospital. She has been bleeding for a few days. She begins to cry. I can't help but wonder what future will hold for the people I encountered. Will Amila find a way out for her children? Will Peter be freed from his violent history and Auntie from her haunting past?
I just remember, but I don't, you know? I forgive him. I can't forget. Those are things to remember. Because every time I look at my skin and them cut this, I keep remembering. Because even when you go in front of the mirror, you see them cut on your face, you must remember. That's the only thing I tell myself. I had a wrong partner in life. I choose a wrong partner in life.
But I'm glad I grew up in an area where we learn about violence and crime and everything. So when we go out in the world, we know how to approach ourselves, you know. Not because I come from the area with crime and violence and smoking and abuse. You must turn out to be like that. We could make a change.
You find, you know, the famous Peter is getting soft. What am I calling soft? But, you know, trying for like change my life around and do something better with it. But ain't got nothing better to do. That's the thing about it. Because tomorrow comes, you understand what I'm saying? I got something serious to do. I gonna do it because I got to survive. You understand what I'm saying? It's simple like that.
Somebody say that to me. I feel wonderful, as wonderful as can be. It makes me wanna say same thing to somebody new. And by the way, I've been meaning to say, I think you're wonderful too. Living your life in this most honest way. Living and praying on your finished day. Oh, what a joy.
Elijah, that's a man of God.
And you hear someone say, I think you're wonderful. And somebody says that to me, I feel wonderful. As wonderful can be, it makes me wanna say the same thing to somebody.
Oh, what's his name? I forget that.
Elijah. To say, I think you're wonderful too. I think you're wonderful when somebody says that to me. I feel wonderful as can be. It makes me wanna say the same thing to somebody new. And by the way, I've been meaning to say that I think you're wonderful too. When we practice this phrase in the most honest way, find something special in someone each day. Lift up the world one heart at a time. It all starts by saying this one simple line. I think you're wonderful when somebody says that to me. I feel wonderful as can be. It makes me wanna say the same thing to somebody new. And by the way, I've been meaning to say